everybody. Welcome into Talking Fitchburg on this Wednesday, January 27th, 2021. I'm Jeremy Crosby, and I'm hoping you had a wonderful day. You bundled up as you head out this morning, and even as we cut into the evening time, it is just bitterly cold. And that's because of that new snow on the ground and cold temperatures to follow that front. And now we're gearing up for some more snow. Yeah. Pile it on, I say. This weekend, chance for some more snow. And, of course, being as far out as is, we're not sure exactly what trajectory this is going to take. But since we just had this last one and we learned what happens when the snowstorm moves just a slightly bit north, you get a little bit more snow. So we'll see what that brings us. I was checking ahead in the forecast to see, and it looks like we level out starting next week with temperatures anyways back up to close to 30. So which is like a major warm-up. When you think about it, just saying. We got a busy show for you here today. We'll get you the latest on the headlines, of course. We're going to bring you a new thing coming to Fact TV, the Fact TV Enterprise, or the City of Fitchburg Enterprise, however you want to say it, podcasting. We're going to talk about, meet the person that's behind a new show from the Fitchburg Senior Center and more. Eric Miller will be on our show today. He's a man of many different hats, and you'll learn about all of that in the new podcast coming up. Plus, we're talking about COVID, it's Corona, COVID, whatever you want to say. We're talking about the scams related to the vaccine. We've already heard of people delivering fake vaccines and so much more. So we want to make sure you stay protected and don't get scammed out there on anything related to COVID-19. So check in with Tiffany at the Better Business Bureau. That's coming up in just a little bit of time. But first, we do kick things off here with our headlines, and we're going to be talking about indefinitely confined information related to voting. And you're like, what is this guy talking about? Yes, as the ballots head out, for those of you in Fitchburg residents who previously indicated on their absentee ballot that you are indefinitely confined, you'll be receiving a letter in the mail, thus what's on your screen right now, with the absentee ballot. The purpose of this correspondence is to confirm the absentee voter status for future elections. A letter will be sent by the clerk's office department the week of January 25th. Those who receive letters will have 30 days to respond. Otherwise, their voting status will remain as indefinitely confined. And absentee ballots will continue to be mailed to the address on record. Copy of the letter to be mailed is, again, referenced here on the screen for your convenience. Only voters who have previously indicated that they are definitely confined will receive this letter. So some municipalities, you get this letter separately. And we're trying to save some of the postage here and send it out with your ballot. So so you know what that is, and you'll have the options there that you can choose from on your screen. All right, talking about that snow and ice, well, it's always a reminder to remove that snow and ice. Yeah, and we have an ordinance for that. Property owners are required to keep sidewalks clear of snow and ice so that pedestrians can navigate safely through Fitchburg. And you have until the 6 p.m. the next day to have all of that stuff cleared out. And if you can't get it completely off, then you got to put down some type of substance to prevent somebody from slipping. So maybe you have an ice layer under the snow that you can't get off immediately. You got to put something down like salt, sand, or other suitable substance to prevent that ice from being dangerous until such time that it can be removed. Failure to do this, by the way, is a fine up to $187. So please do your part and clear out those sidewalks and from snow and ice. Also, too, I should throw in there, might as well clean around those fire hydrants as well. Clear that 3-foot radius. Even the more farther, the bigger the space, the easier it is, by the way, for the firefighters to take care of that. All right, free health and wellness screenings. We talked about this, but we'll make sure it's on your radar. This is coming up here real quick in collaboration with Edgewood College School of Nursing. It'll be held on Thursday, February 18th, 9 a.m. to noon at the Fitchburg Senior Center. But key here is it's only by appointment only. So 270-4290, that's what you need to call. And all COVID safety precautions will be taken when they are doing this. So please, please be getting yourself signed up as soon as possible when doing this, so you can get in on this check. And it is free. So what's better than free and health checks? I can't think of anything better. Public information meeting for intersection improvements at County Highway MM in McCoy Road. This meeting is coming up tomorrow night. Be at 6:30 p.m. and it will discuss the improvements at that intersection of County Highway MM and McCoy Road. Online attendance is encouraged, but you can come in person, which will be held at the council chambers for participants for City of Fitchburg. That is, by the way, in City Hall, 5520 Lacey Road. Website, get the latest information about the project, also where you can sign up if you want to be providing any input for this public information meeting. So if you got to ask questions or want to comment on it, you have to sign up online to get the link for that. And of course, you can just watch this meeting at Fact TV if you want to just learn about the project itself. We'll highlight some of that here on Talking Fitchburg on Friday. All right, I got a scam alert to tell you about. Contact someone or somebody. And these utility scams are happening quite a bit. But if you receive a contact for somebody claiming to be from MG&E or any other utility company threatening a disconnection, this is a scam. MG&E does not not disconnecting customers during COVID-19. You can call immediately at 252-7222 before they take any action. For information, you can check on MG&E, but I would extend this to any utilities. Check and see what they're doing. But these for MG&E, they're not shutting off any utilities right now during the pandemic. But I've seen this nationwide that there are quite a bit of utility scams going around. So I want to make sure you stay protected and know that that one is a scam alert to be on the lookout for. And you got to report these, folks. You really do got to report these. All right, finally, be prepared for February 16th, the primary. Do you have the accessible ID, Andrew? People want to know. Drum roll, please. Yes. He's just a quiet guy. He says yes. Be prepared for the February 16th primary by having your acceptable ID. Well, Andrew, the folks want to know if you're ready to vote. Wisconsin voters must show acceptable photo ID when voting at the polls on election day. You can get a Wisconsin state ID card for free, Andrew, at the Division of Motor Vehicles. All you got to do is call the DMV voter hotline, 844-588-1069, to learn more about the documents you need to bring to get this done. But, yeah, you should get it done. And Andrew's kind enough here to show you all the photo IDs that are acceptable for the election season. So please get that taken care of if you haven't done so already. Again, check with Wisconsin DMV for more information. All right, that does it for our headlines. Coming up next, we're introducing you to Eric Miller. He is a man of many different jobs, but he's going to be talking about a new podcast here for the Fitchburg Senior Center. Next, right here on Talking Fitchburg.
I may never have met you. We don't go way back. Maybe we wouldn't even be friends if we did. But when you wear a mask, you have my respect. Because your mask doesn't protect you. It protects me. I wear my mask to protect you. Mask up, America.
Score going to the playoffs.
I can't believe I missed that.
Every time I'm buzzed, I spend too much time on my phone. What? I should take your phone away.
No. I'll call for a ride. Hey, why does my face look like that?
I'm playing with these new face filters.
Okay, you know what?
Yep, that's mine.
I'm gonna need that back.
No.
Kevin!
Hello, everybody. Welcome back into Talking Fitchburg. Joining me today from the Fitchburg Senior Center, somebody who wears many hats, in fact, I have Eric Miller here. Eric, welcome to Talking Fitchburg. You are the future of, no, I'm just kidding. You are the future of the city of Fitchburg in some ways, but truly you are a one of a kind employee that gets to wear a couple of different hats. And today we're going to talk about the senior center and the work you're doing down there, but welcome to the show. And how are you doing?
Thanks for having me. I'm doing well. How about you?
I'm doing good. We've been working together here for the last month and a half or so, and you've been doing podcasts. And so now you get to finally see the reverse role and see me actually do some type of on-air work while we've been coaching you to do all of the work. And what you've been working on is actually pretty cool. It's a podcast, and we'll talk a little bit about that in a minute. But Eric, what are you doing? Tell us a little bit about yourself and what you're doing down at the Fitchburg Senior Center.
Well, I've been a city employee with the Fitchburg for about 5 years now. I've been a police officer there and recently took military leave. I'm working out at the Air National Guard 115 Fighter Wing. I'm a cop out there as well and backfilling for a deployment team. So I'm currently doing that, but while I'm doing that, I'm also going to school for my bachelor's in social work degree. And for my internship, I decided to select the Fitchburg Senior Center. So I'm working with all the ladies and one gentleman down there with trying to better our community as far as social work working and doing that.
Yeah, and Eric, you like you said, you've been employed with the city of Fitchburg for many years. How important, I think we've talked about this, but how important is it for kind of tying the social work? Why do you choose social work when you have the police officer role as well? Why are you bringing those together?
Well, having a social work degree, I think, helps when it comes to law enforcement, right? A lot of our jobs as cops is social work related things. As cops, we wear several different hats, and we're constantly trying to be the mediator, if you will, and working to come up with people's solutions. Lots of times, it's lots of stuff that we do. It's not what you see in the TVs, where we're out there fighting crime, breaking doors down, stuff like that. A lot of it is just trying to work with the community and see what the community needs and then try to address those issues. Lots of times, you know, you're dealing with your neighbor issues where, you know, this is my side of the fence or this is your side of the fence or things along those lines. So it's nice to have that social work background so then you can understand how to communicate effectively with others and problem solve and then address the issue. And lots of times what we do is we're forwarding issues to other city departments, such as the senior center, right? So a lot of our elder folks that we're dealing with, if they have mental health issues or any other issues, right? Maybe they need help with getting a ramp or stuff like that, we'll direct them to the senior center. And that goes for, you know, public works and parks and all kinds of stuff that we do with the city.
Yeah, there's a lot that happens for a police department, and I'm glad you shared a little bit of that perspective because that's something once I came to the city and learning more and more about what the department does on a day-to-day basis, there's a lot of things that you don't know behind the scenes that's happening in policing today, and it's very very interesting, but it's a lot of changing hats. As you are working on your degree and the work that you've done in the senior center, what have been some of the benefits, I guess, from your internship thus far? What have you learned perspective-wise? We've got some great social workers down there, so I'm sure they're helping you out as well, but what have your experiences been like?
It's been a great time through the senior center. It was nice that Sarah Folkers and Amy are the two social workers down there. And Sarah Folkers, her husband, was a cop with us for quite some time, so she understands what it's like to work shift work. And you know, it's nice that if I come in late or something, they understand. Oh well, he was working nights the night before and got held over, things like that. So it's nice in that perspective, but then also learning from them. Just kind of seeing how they interact. I don't have much of experience working with elder folks, which is one of the reasons why I picked the senior center. I've been a personal trainer for 11 years, you know, doing things like that. So I've worked with a lot of different people, different, you know, backgrounds and all that kind of stuff, and trying to learn how to, you know, see what seniors need and see a different, you know, lens, right? Look through a different lens is pretty crucial to kind of just be more mindful of what's going on around you. And also just seeing what other departments do in the city of Fitchburg. You know, why we constantly hear, well, why can't we as police get this, or why can't we get this? And then you start realizing, you go into a different sector of the city and you realize, oh, well, they also need this and they're not getting this. So why aren't they getting this? But then it comes back down to funding. So there's always, you see the bigger picture of things when you start working in cross departments, which is pretty cool.
Yeah, absolutely. Another cross department. So that's why I started off this interview saying you wear many hats, and this is probably the first time I've ever had to say it in such a fashion, because not only are you a police officer in the National Guard working on your degree, helping out seniors, the community with the social work, but you're also being asked to do a podcast as well for the Senior Center. And that's where we've started to work with you, and we've had a blast of working on this project. But tell us what you're doing with the Fitchburg Senior Center podcast.
So the podcast was doing bi-weekly. We just switched it to do monthly, as it was just a little bit too much for me to handle with all my hats that I'm wearing. But it's social work with Eric. Social work scoop with Eric. Sorry, can't talk today apparently.
We're still working on that name, right?
yep. So that's what we're calling it right now. And it's essentially just a topic a day, or a topic podcast. And the last one was about veteran benefits. So I just go in a little bit more detail of what the problem is, things in areas to focus on, and how you can improve that problem. So sometimes it's not even just problem-based. There was a time before where we were talking about different types of housing and places you can put a loved one. So there's all kinds of different topics that we'll be discussing.
Yeah, and we're still working on getting this launched through a podcast software, if you will, where people can download this through a podcast app. And those details will be coming soon. But Eric, as far as getting information out to the community using this technology, some of you will be like, well, does the older population use podcast? I think this is interesting because it's great technology and really heavily used actually by all generations.
Exactly. Yeah. It's something that's going to be pretty beneficial, I think, when it comes to that. I think there's, you know, obviously some flaws when it comes to representing our lower income communities where they may not have access to internet or tablets or things like that. But I am working on another project, which is trying to include the Latino community. I've just got a language line service for us, so then we can have our staff using language services, and then we can be able to open up more programs in-house once in that time comes with COVID, obviously, but be able to include the Latino community with what we do as well. So that'll also be probably discussed in future podcasts as well. So.
Absolutely. And we're going to have you, I'm sure we'll have you back on our show here, Talking Fitchburg. But we want people definitely to check out your podcast. I think it's awesome going topic-based too, and having the time to actually explain things. You're sharing great resources during those topics, breaking it down. And it's a good perspective. You bring in a really good perspective that a lot of people don't have, which I think makes it unique and makes it work well. Eric, as we wrap up here, what do you want to tell your future fans as you work through this?
If you have any ideas, send me an email. We'd love to hear any more ideas for topics. And look forward to hearing more and telling us more topics for you guys on the podcast series.
We're still turning you. We're going to turn you into a TV guy one of these days. We're working on it.
Who knows?
You're getting better. Every day you're getting better, my friend. Eric, thank you so much for taking the time. Look forward to working with you and getting this podcast out. And thanks for everything that you're doing day in and day out with all the hats you do wear.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Thanks for having me.
Betcha. All right. We'll have Eric back on the show, and we will share that information where you can find those future podcasts here on Fact TV. We'll take a quick break. More to come. You are watching TF.
You could be spreading the coronavirus without realizing you have it. So follow guidance from authorities where you live and do your part. It's important to limit in-person interaction with anyone outside of your immediate household, but phone and video chat are safe ways to connect. It's also important to limit any social gathering. This advice applies to people of any age, including teens and younger adults. Visit coronavirus.gov for the latest information.
After you joined our family, it was like, I really do feel complete now.
Our hearts are made stronger by how we treat others.
Put her there.
The light you share can impact those around you, but so can the darkness.
Later, twerps!
Did Pete saying mean things bother ya?
So when you reach out to another person, take a moment to consider how they will feel and let your heart be the key to making a difference. Because of you, someone's entire day, year, or even life can change.
In every heart, there's hope.
We're all just trying to keep things running for those who rely on us.
Ready!
That's why we don't have time to be sick with the flu. And especially this year, no one has time to get sick. Get a flu shot for yourself and those around you too.
Welcome back into Talking Fitchburg. Joining me today from the Better Business Bureau right here in Southern Wisconsin, it's Tiffany Schultz. Welcome back to the show, Tiffany. How are you doing?
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. And we're starting off this year, New Year here, talking about COVID-19 vaccine scams. Very important. There's a lot of information out there on the vaccines. I've heard and seen reports from the clinics and hospitals saying, you know, be patient and, you know, they're not doing waiting lists. They're not, you know, it's just rolling out as it rolls out, right? With anything else, it seems like when something comes out for helpfulness or whatever, comes with scams. And we want to make sure that we get that information out to protect everybody from being scammed. So what are you hearing out there as it comes to these vaccine scams?
With the distribution of the vaccine, scammers are right behind it. And there's two versions that are going on out there. They're either phishing for your personal information by trying to send you a link saying they have more information about the vaccine, or they're offering you to buy phony vaccines that don't even exist in a retail store or online. So be very wary if you do get a phone call, email, text message, pop up on your computer. The only way that you can get this vaccine is wait your turn in line for health professionals.
Yeah, super important there. When it comes to any type of scams, there are a lot of common denominators in these things. And I can see here in some of the notes that these are things we've talked about in the past when it comes to different types of scams of any form.
Research carefully. If somebody tells you something and it sounds too good to be true, it probably is too good to be true. So you want to do your research before you act on anything that they're telling you. If they're telling you something that you haven't heard from official news sources, you really need to dig deep. In this case, call your doctor, call your local health department. That right now there is no vaccine that you can get online or through mail order. The only way that you can get it is through your healthcare professional. So be very, very wary about this specific scam that's out there.
Yeah, I know with a health provider that I have, they've sent out messages directly to specific medical accounts and stuff, kind of keeping people up to date. But that definitely is somewhere that, you know, confirm and make sure that you do have that direct communication with your health provider so you don't get scammed here on that. How to spot coronavirus vaccine con artists? What can we do otherwise to stay safe?
Do your research. Like I said, if it sounds too good to be true, it probably is too good to be true. Check with your doctor, you know, sign up for their email list. Your local health department is a great resource as well as the CDC. So all of that information, nobody is going to be calling you right now and offering you a vaccine. And usually if they do call you and offer you something like that, they're probably going to tell you that it's secret or for a cost. There is no cost involved in this vaccine right now either. So those are red flags to watch out for.
Yeah, and anything with the immediate action, a lot of phishing scams or what scammers are doing here are high pressure scams. They're trying to do like take action right now, and that should be a big red flag.
They don't want you to have time to think about it or to research it. They want you to take action right away. And they may say it's only valid during this phone call, or you won't be able to get it if you don't get this phone call from me or purchase it right now. So all red flags to watch out for while we go through this uncertain time and, you know, wait our turn in line for this vaccine.
Yeah, and of course they're preying on the vulnerable and the innocent when it comes to these things. So, you know, the too good to be true and stuff, when desperate times is when they're attacking you, when you're most vulnerable. Finally here, making sure that the URLs are real and you're really actually getting a website or a link to something that actually is legit. You do have some tips there for us.
Anything legit is going to end in .gov. If somebody sends you a link, .com, .org, .ca, just that something that doesn't make sense, it should raise a red flag as well. So really do your research. All that information that's out there is public. And if you can't find it on a government website, it probably doesn't exist. So really be careful, be vigilant at this time, and have some patience as you wait your turn in line.
And you do recommend that people report scams, whether they were actually scammed out of money or information or not.
Please report it to us at bbb.org/scamtracker. That information helps us warn the community and put other alerts out there so other people don't get scammed. Scam Tracker is a great tool for you to use, whether you're just looking for information, if you've been scammed out of money, or if you haven't been scammed out of money. Please report it to us. So important that we get this information into the hands of other consumers.
Absolutely. Tiffany, thank you so much for all the tips. If people do want to learn more about the Scam Tracker or just more about BBB, where can they go?
BBB.org is a great resource.
Fantastic. Tiffany, thank you so, so very much. We'll see you back here next month.
Thanks for having me.
You bet. Tiffany here from BBB helping us out each and every month with some great tips. Again, hit up the website, bbb.org, for more information. Take a quick break. More to come. You're watching TF.
So how was work?
It was 1,300 hours. My math class from 302 was in the trenches. Davy Roth had it the worst. Fractions were coming at him left and right. He just didn't get the damn things. 2 days ago, I tried to teach him what 1/4 of 1/2 was using different sizes of blocks. Yesterday, I tried again by dividing up pizza. Both missions failed.
Oh, no.
But today, I was ready. I created a combat math game where the only way to beat the enemy is to outfraction them. Davy conquered every last denominator. My game was so successful, the principal is deploying it to math squadrons all over the school.
Anywho, how was your day?
Oh, today my boss treated the office to salad wraps.
Salad wraps.
I know.
See on page 4 that the projections need to be blood. Next Thursday?
Seriously, Thursday? Can't do that.
This is really inconvenient.
I have yoga that day.
I have no time for this.
So.
I can't do Thursday, but I can do Friday.
Disasters? Don't plan ahead. You can. Talk to your loved ones about how you're going to be ready in an emergency. Don't wait. Communicate.
Welcome back into Talking Fitchburg. Wrapping up the show for the day, I want to thank Eric Miller, the Fitchburg police officer, and now learning how to be a social worker, for stopping in. And you want to keep up on those podcasts. They'll be up on the Senior Center's website. Andrew's working on it very hard. He's on top of that project, so very excited for that. And Tiffany at Better Business Bureau, we thank her for her time as well. As we wrap up here, remember to stay connected with Fact TV. It's super easy, everybody. Have a great day.